In the same manner, no, we had a hearing in the Senate, and the same statements were heard from NTC chairman, and we were assured by the NTC chairman that a provisional authority can be given. No? And mm-hmm. considering that the provisional authority has been given many, many times, ito, hindi lang to sa big networks, even small networks were given provisional authority. And this is because of timing issues. Sometimes Congress takes a while to approve franchises, and it's unfair for existing operators to just completely shut down. So the remedy for that is NTC issues provisional authorities. And once the franchise has been given out, the franchise will take over legally.
So the NTC, Commissioner Gamaliel Cordoba, hindi ko siya makalimutan kasi yung pangalang Gamaliel, nabasa ko yun sa The Book of Acts, yung Gamaliel the High Priest. Anyway, his standing is as the High Priest of the NTC. Now, in any case, he stood before Congress, he stood before the Senate, and made a, what was it? Ano, usapang lasing ba yun? Verbal commitment ba yun? Or because he was in the Senate, someone told me he swore an oath
Correct.
To say the truth and nothing but the truth. And therefore, anything he said there had the power of a contract.
Correct.
Alam ko, biruin ko lang kayo o magbiru lang ako ng masama sa hearing, pwede nyo na akong tirahin ng contempt. Now, in this Correct. Case, he made a commitment did he make a commitment to issue actual provisional authority?
I was there at the hearing, and in fact he passed on the buck to the Department of Justice. I remember he was saying before we can decide, we have to get a legal opinion from the Department of Justice. The Department of Justice Secretary was there, and the Department of Justice Secretary made a categorical statement that the principle of equity will prevail in this type of mm-hmm. circumstance. Meaning, kung nag-ooperate ka na at maraming nakasalalay dito, this can be a justification, an argument for you to issue a provisional authority. And he was relieved. I remember that. Hindi ko makalimutan because that was a point of contention at that time. So he was relieved that, sabi niya, andito na pala yung DOJ, meron ng justification, therefore we can issue a provisional authority. That statement is a very important statement because that guided us, the senators, and also Congress in terms of how to approach this franchise and what pace and what process we will have to take in order to approve that franchise. Of course, we respect each other's process. No, we respect the process for Congress. Congress respects our process. But that statement guided the pace and guided the process. And then all of a sudden, iba pala yung gagawin mo. So, binigyan mo kami ng isang statement na sinundan namin as a guide, pero iba pala yung nangyari. That's why we were quite surprised, no? And it can be, for me, no? It can be a justification for contempt because at that point in time, you gave us a statement that we held and we used to guide us in our decision-making.
The little I know about Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano, bagamat Christian siya, medyo in fairness to the Speaker, he took a beating on this one and he said there will be a day of reckoning. Congressman Benny Abante has already proposed the abolition of the NTC and let the DICT handle it, etc. What are the sentiments of your colleagues in the Senate?
Well, we know Speaker Allen is a very meticulous person, no? And he is a very experienced public servant. Matagal na siyang naglilingkod sa atin. And his style is really to approach things very meticulously. And he scrutinizes things very closely. And that's why he wants to scrutinize the franchise of ABS. And that's their prerogative. In fact, that's the job of Congress and the Senate to scrutinize bills very closely. But having said that, no, That's why during their first hearing, and then also in the Senate, we asked point blank, no? We asked NTC and DOJ, if the time comes that a franchise will not be issued, what are the remedies? And the provisional authority was in order at that time. Yeah, that's why nagulat kami na nangyari ito, especially at this time. No, we have a pandemic in their midst, and we need the flow information as fast as possible. And we were caught. I was caught off guard, and many of our colleagues were caught off guard.
So, are you guys going to support the abolition of the NTC?
We will have to study this very carefully because NTC has other jobs also. For example, regulating telecom. I think the problem is not with the NTC, but the problem is with the persons inside NTC, the decision makers. We will have to look at the persons instead of the organization.